for 27 during the season against the Avalanche.
Yzerman is on the ice, and he has the puck through center. Yzerman moving up over the line, gets in the slot. Won't shoot it from there. On a sharp angle, comes out a bit. Coffey will give it back to him. Now he centers it, gets it again. Yzerman back to the line, the shot.
There.
And it's Lidstrom taking it from Coffey.
No!
Back to Coffey. That's broken up. Cleared by Gusarov. They come in 2-on-1. Yell. Great boom. Oh, they score. Coffey knocked it in his own net. Out of the net was Osgood. Coffey was left in front. And he thought he was tearing it off his stick and in. A shorthanded goal for Colorado.
Paul will get it back if you give him time.
That came at 44 seconds. A shorthanded goal. Avalanche can't bring it in over the line. Young is turning back with it. And he rolled it in there. Shot rolls down in front. They think it's in. The red light is on. It's a goal. And Detroit will argue that. It bounced high, came down in the crease. Nobody could see it from this side of the Joe Louis Arena. But the red light came on, and the referee was there to make the sign. Sakic remains there talking to the referee.
Well, the goal judge put the light on, and as he did, Koharski gave the signal for a goal.
Sandis Ozilinch to center. Stopped in his tracks near center ice. A 2-on-1, Larionov coming in with Primo. And the pass in for the Coffey score! Primo assisting, 5:33 the time. Cicerelli will chase Gusarov. Out to Ricci, circles through center ice. Ricci put it ahead. Score! Keith! A quick shot from inside the line. And the Colorado Avalanche take the first game. Keith scoring at 17:31 on the first overtime. And it's a 3-2 win for Colorado.
Mike Keane gets his second goal of these 96 playoffs. It was a real quick wrist shot that I really think caught Osgood by surprise.
Broken up there by Taylor. And the Red Wings try and clear it. They can't do it this time. Ozilinch keeps it in. Young looking to center. Puts it off in front. Rebound scores! Sakic! Joe Sakic has done it again for Colorado.
Give Joe Sakic many of those opportunities sitting at the doorstep with a wide open net. He is not going to miss. Osgood robbed him in overtime, of course, in game one here at Joe Louis Arena, not this time.
Eventually, he's credited with a shorthanded goal. Mary behind his own goal.
Let's go, let's go!
Cicerelli has it batted away. Stephen Young in front, and a score for Reichel! Warren Reichel makes it 2-0, Colorado.
What a pass from Stefan Yell. It wasn't on the ground, and somehow Warren Reichel got a hold of it in midair. A little bunt, and it went over the shoulder of Osgood.
10 seconds in a 4-on-4. Scott Young takes the quick wrist shot, deflected well over top of the goal. And now the team's back at 5 aside as Foot and McCarty are out of the box. Center catch up. He scores! Sandis Ozilinch, 3-0 Colorado.
They are taking this game over. The Avalanche have taken control of the tempo, the defensive play, and the confidence with the puck. And once again, Sandis Ozilinch.
Red Wings get it out of the zone. Looking for the first goal. Up they come. It's at the line and the long shot high. And over the net. Fedorov going behind the net. It is centered. What a play!
I think it hit Patrick Waugh and got in behind him. 1-0, Detroit leading.
And you can bet on the Red Wing bench, they're screaming to each other, he's human, he's human. And McCarty gets a soft goal on Patrick Waugh.
A point coming in to take the hit. He did. The puck rolled ahead of him to the other side. Ramsey fired one, tipped in front of the net. Here comes Kozlov. From the corner, center, they score! In and out like a bullet, Lidstrom came in and got the pass 30 feet in front of Waugh. And suddenly, it's 2-0. Detroit Red Wings are leading.
Lidstrom came off the point when the puck was behind the Avalanche net, and then he just started it toward the net.
Couldn't play it. Forsberg all the way back in his own zone to try and start the power play up. There's a pass. That's a dandy to Deadmarsh. Stop. Rebound. Score. They get a power play goal. Lemieux getting the rebound. Carries it in. Cicerelli going for the net. Here's the shot. That's stopped by Keane, who fell in front of it. Cicerelli behind the net. Fell. Kozlov looking back to the line. Again, Fedorov shot. Scores! Fedorov took the shot, but standing in front of the net was Dino Cicerelli. And I wouldn't be surprised if Cicerelli gets credit for that goal to make it 3-1 Detroit.
Now that was a bullet shot from the point, and you're right, Cicerelli did get a stick on it, I'm almost sure. There are few players in the National League any better at maintaining their position in front and then getting their stick on it.
Back to the net, making contact. Quick shot, score! Right off the draw. Lynch starts, Forsberg up to the line. He lost in a breakaway. Two of them. Konstantinov scores. Konstantinov on a breakaway. And he made the move of a forward, deking the goalie Patrick Waugh. And a shorthanded goal makes it 4-2 Detroit.
I don't know how many times you've seen in the Stanley Cup playoffs over the years a 2-on-0 break when you were killing a penalty. And watch this play. He's done that before, I think. He held Patrick Waugh for a second and stuck it up on the backhand.
Yzerman after it with Larionov knocked to the ice. Yzerman comes over to find it. Yzerman pulling away with Cicerelli. Yzerman sliding it back to the line. Fedorov at the other point. Larionov goes to him. Fedorov gives it up again. Gets it back again. Shoots. Big rebound. Larionov scores. Larionov scoring a power play goal for Detroit. And they're now leading 5-2.
Well, remember Scotty Bowman in our opening. We have to have people go to the net. And when you look at the replay of this goal, you're going to see three Detroit Red Wings in front of the net.
He's up the center. Sakic with him. Low shot. Big rebound. Cleared away by the Red Wings with 20 seconds left in the period. Here's a centering pass. Adam Foote scores! A bullet!
You're down 2 instead of 3. This could be a real asset.
Look out, not done yet. Deadmarsh scores! Deadmarsh! Can you believe it? 2 goals, 7 seconds apart. Brand new hockey game. And we're still in the second period. 5-4 is the score. Great finish to the second for Colorado. Maybe a good start to the third as Sakic comes in. Oh, and he came close with that quick shot. Fedorov gets it ahead. Out to center, McCarty dropped it back. Lidstrom driving. What scores? Lidstrom from outside the blue line. Goals are coming fast and furiously here in Denver. That makes it 6-4 Detroit.
That was a long shot outside the blue line by Lidstrom. We know he can fire the puck. He's already scored one on a good shot tonight.
Trouble passing through center ice. Not much room. Or skating, for that matter. Doug Brown trying to knock it away. Good play by Curtis Lysacek. Up for Sakic. Sakic. Detmar. Open shot. Scores!
Joe Sakic had eyes on the side of his head on this one. Perfect pass to Adam Detmars, who took his time. He realized that Oskar would have to dive back, so he made sure it was sitting down flat.
Eisenman came away with the puck, though. Lidstrom able to hold it in. Avalanche challenging the puck here. Larionov chases down for Eisenman. Steve Eisenman. Larionov the high slot. Cicerelli right in front of Patrick Waugh. Near side, Fedorov shot. Sight! Score! Tipped in! And guess who? Dino Cicerelli again!
What? 22 Cicerelli move over and gets his stick on it like he so often does.
In his 3 years with the franchise, and he's a very solid defenseman. Knocked away, Sakic in front of the net. Shot, score! The light didn't come on! The light did not come on!
But Andy Van Helman immediately signaled in. He was pointing to the underside of the net saying, that baby went in.
Great setup, and Sakic makes it a 2-1 Colorado lead. Came in the zone, though. Osgood there. Yui Krupp knocks down the attempted clear. Centered it. Has nobody there. Draper fell down. Guzrov holds it in. Guzrov tipped it into the corner. Bergeron doing battle over there. Primo with the hit on. Puck swept up to the point. Guzrov doesn't take it. Near side to Yui Krupp. Krupp, the wrist shot. Scores!
Shot from the point that Osgood has not seen yet. The Red Wings had two chances to get it out.
Time running out in Detroit with 6:13 left. Fedorov trying to go through the middle. 3-on-2 break the other way now. Detmars, hit shot. Blocker saved by Osgood. Fedorov starts the other way. Three back though. Johnson center. Boom! Shot! Score! Fedorov comes the other way, both teams changing at the 2-on-3. Fedorov looking out for help, and the guy's coming off the bench, finds it. Brown, Batisov, his shot blocked up deep by Young. Batisov, Konstantinov were both there. Fedorov center, Brown shot! Lemieux in the middle with it. Lemieux moved over to help. Lapointe had it jammed up. Good play by Lapointe to free that up. Comes 2-on-2 the other way. Eisenman. Larionov is cutting in the middle. Centering pass. Just tipped away. Yui Krupp shot. Wide. Konstantinov. They score! Igor Larionov!
Season. He's played spectacularly well in setting people up. Sakic moving it in. Ricci with it. Sakic cutting. Ricci in front. The tip scores! And it continues. Red hot flurry. Mike Ricci, a power play goal. And Colorado Konstantinov's penalty.
Mike Ricci driving the net against Sanders to call him back, so he acts as an extra set of eyes for Oselin.
One back to the point. Detroit sent in. Scores! Paul Coffey gunned it in. Patrick Wild never saw it. The shot and could not. Power play Avalanche tipped ahead. They've got a 3-on-2 down the middle. Oselin's in center, reaching, scores! He's got both power play goals, and the Red Wings lead again is cut to one.
Wow, what a break for the Avalanche. Look at the Detroit Red Wings. They are stunned because it looked like it was going to be a sure out.
Patrick Waugh playing the bouncing puck behind the net, not very successful. Had a dump it away from Doug Brown, who moved in behind. Fedorov stepped up, so does Coffey. Fedorov's got it. Kozlov in the middle. He's shot on Waugh's wide. In front of the net, Doug Brown doing battle. They can't define it, but it's always there. Red Wings up 4-2. Lesagian moved that one up, couldn't control. Here's Martin LaPointe. He's got time. LaPointe moving in on one. Save, rebound. Score! Greg Johnson!
Shot it in back of the net where Primo was going in. Primo getting out front, but he's tied up. And Gettmarsh is away. Corbe with him. The pass, Sakic scores! Joe Sakic! Time though. They're in on the puck in the corner. Back to the line. Coffey chopped it in. Out front. Quick shot. Doesn't reach the net. Doesn't get cleared though. Coffey shoots it in the crowd. Score! Coffey again just directing the puck on the net. And it hits somebody in front.
It hits Sylvain Lefebvre's right foot and goes in, so the goal goes to Coffey.
43 seconds left in the penalty.
Power play. Sakic, who usually plays the point, is not.
Kamansky feeding it in to Sakic. In the slot, scores!
Closing in on Reggie Leach's and Yari Curry's record for most goals in a playoff year.
Ricci was grabbed from behind. And the Red Wings will clear the zone. Up Colorado on it, they bring it back in. Deadmarsh left it for Oselin. His pass shot, stop rebound, score! Ricci! 3-1, Colorado! Take any penalties against this fired up Colorado team tonight. That's another power play goal. That's the next round. That's exactly what they have in mind. Detroit with other ideas. They want to go back home for 7. Here's Forsberg. He scores! Well, Forsberg finally 4-1 now, folks.
Seconds left on the power play. Sent in around the boards by Lidstrom. Lefebvre had it, lost it. Back up for Lidstrom. He's got a shot. Takes it. And blocked up deep by Keane. Blocked again by Keane. Mike Keane, one with a body and one with a stick. Power play is over. Center, Shanahan scores! Brendan Shanahan in a 5-on-5 has given Detroit a 1-0 lead.
Boy, you heard of bang-bang plays? Put this one in that category. Came out from behind the net, and Brendan Shanahan just hit it immediately.
There to help prevent that, but two posts were hit on that, and then Vernon had to come up with a save. Back in front again, shot, score! One goal lead is gone! Joe Sakic! Knocked away to the near side. This is not a power play. Although it sure looks that way, the way Detroit is holding it in the zone. Finally, the rink wide gets it out. Detroit's got two back. On the crisscross with Richie. Lemieux, center, shot, score! Richie from Lemieux! 2-1 Avalanche! So he played it, but didn't get it out. Murphy centered, and a save made by Waugh on the tip-in by Tomas Sandstrom.
It was Sandstrom that made the good play in forcing Patrick Waugh to move out of his net and try to put that back into play.
Ozilek in the middle, open shot, score! Power play goal! Their leader, Scott Young! Off the back of Lemieux that time. Mariano waiting for the Red Wings to clear. Now the Red Wings will change. Bad pass. And they've got three back. Kaminsky into the middle. Himself. Kaminsky moves it in. Shot. Burn. Save. Rebound. Score. There'll be a crease check on this one. But I think the puck may have been there first.
I don't know, Gary. It's going to be really close. Don Gorharski's signal that the puck was in the net. His linesman Wayne Boddy and Brad Lazarowicz both came over to him immediately and said, you better check this one. There's Claude Lemieux. No, sir, he was not in the crease. He was not in the crease. He ended up poking it under Vernon's legs.
Minute 44 on the penalty to the Avalanche. Detroit on the power play with 3:17 on the period. Lidstrom! Patrick Roy came up at the angle. Sergei Fedorov drops it offside of the net. Lariano! Score! Tipped in! Lariano had Shanahan on the wide side. Passed it over. Bounced up over Patrick Roy. It is a power play goal. Crawford saying, check upstairs. Was anybody in the crease? It's become the call on every goal.
Yeah, they may do that, but I don't think it's going to work. It looked like a good goal, and it was a broken play. That's why I said, you got to keep trying. You've got to keep getting pucks in front. It may go off a leg. It may go off a skate, and that's what the Red Wings did. That was huge. We're down to 3:09 to go.
Here's Fedorov moving it in. Fedorov in. Shot, and that one was ripped wide. The power play goal that Detroit has credited to Lariano. That was changed during the intermission. Centered, Fedorov scores! Sergei Fedorov! Their second power play goal of the game, and they tied it up at 2.
Just keep doing what you're doing, guys. Scotty Bowman has to be saying that, and the players are responding because Detroit has really dominated not only game one, but game two. Now they've got a tie to work with. Remember, they can come back in the third period. Sergei Fedorov has come out in the third period.
Ozilek in. Ozilek. His blast deflected wide. Konstantinov went down and blocked it. Near side. Dedmarsh. Sakic. Sakic tied up by Fetisov. Puck there, and Detroit will get it. Yzerman just got away from Rene Corbet. Yzerman moves into the middle. Sandstrom with it. Yzerman.
Shot! Save made wide!
What a play by Steve Yzerman. Man, the move that he made to get to the net. Now Mark Crawford wants a review, of course. Who doesn't these days? That's automatic. But the boys in red are loving this. What a great play by Steve Yzerman. Watch him put the puck close to Sandis Ozilinch's skates here. Right there, so that he could blow by him. Patrick Roy made the first save. Gary, you're right, he banked it back out again. The Detroit Red Wings have overcome a 2-0 deficit in this game by sticking with the game plan and slugging it out, and they finally have a lead.
Steve Yzerman, their captain. Now 105 career playoff games on 106 points against Yzerman. Sakic won it, turnaround shot, Young save, man, rebound, deflected away, Lidstrom made the save! Sandy Sosulinski for Deadmarsh, kept it himself, puck checked away, Deadmarsh held it in. Richie redirects it to the corner, Patrick Waugh still in net at the other end. Cleared up, not up, Deadmarsh, up for foot, couldn't get to it, here's a break at center, McCarty!
They deserve to be happy. You saw the reaction on the Detroit bench. They have just stuck with it. This series and a couple of points in this game after the way game one went looked kind of impossible. But the only reason Detroit now has a 4-2 lead started with a save by Nicky Lidstrom, number 5. Otherwise, the game was tied.
Point crashing in there. And it's chipped to center. Here's Fedorov coming off his best game in these playoffs. Trying to twist away from Gusarov. Puts it in front, they score!
Fedorov has been very good. Gains the blue line. Konstantinov's coming in. Kozlov's there. And Kozlov gets
it. Right, Chris, that's a reputation call.
Sakic over to Ozolich. Ozolich walking in. Back to Sakic. Wrist shot. That's blocked by Yzerman. Rebound. Scores! Joe Sakic has tied the game.
Well, and Scotty's saying in the crease. He's going in the crease, And it's going to be close. I think maybe Scott Young was the closest one to in the crease. And we are going upstairs. It's Adam Deadmarsh, who is the closest to the crease, and I don't think there's any doubt that they're not in the crease there. That's going to stand.
Detroit wins the faceoff. Fedosov shot blocked by Klemp. Ricci in deep, knocked down by Kozlov. Here's Kozlov to Brown, shooting it. Ah, down to make the stop, centered by Fedorov. Kozlov looking for it against Ricci. He has it, shoots, scores! The red light is on!
Is going upstairs.
What a shot by Kozlov.
A great shot there on the overhead. There was no doubt that that one was in and nobody in the crease.
It's across the Avalanche zone. Adam Foote able to play it around. It'll be held in by Lidstrom, picked up by Larionov. Lays it off the board. Marty Lapointe will settle it down there. Now Lapointe hands it off for Kozlov as the Wings try to spread it out. Kozlov sends it deep. Larionov center, he can score! It may have bounced in off of Patrick Roy, but it's a power play goal. And the Red Wings, like they did in game three, have struck early and lead it 1-0.
It was a lucky break too, a real lucky break. The Red Wings had patience on the perimeter and the puck was intended for Lapointe in front of the net.
And already in this contest, Igor Larionov has scored a goal for the Red Wings.
Shanahan up the left side. Snaps a shot that's blocked across nearly out of the stick of Lapointe. That can't score! Larionov again! That was a backhander from the hash marks.
And I saw moments ago, and this is no surprise, the Avalanche right now, and I believe it has been the Avalanche officially that have called a timeout. Following the goal, we showed a shot of the bench. Joe Sakic looked up towards Mark Crawford and said, should we call a timeout? And now they've settled them down a little bit.
Time winding down on the Kozlov penalty. Forsberg into the Detroit zone. Stood up there by Larry Murphy. Fedorov tries to clear it. Bounces it to center right. Kozlov is outside. In like a penalty shot. He scores! Kozlov had the presence of mind at center ice to tag up. If he doesn't do that, the play's offside.
And it was awfully close. And it would be his third goal in the last game and a half, and Crawford is just furious. At first glance, he watched the play develop, and he watched it went in the net.
We still have over 3 minutes to go in the second period. It comes to Fedorov. Puts it up on the glass. It bounces out in front of Watch. Hits here for Larionov. Fired wide. Larionov again. Hash marks. LaPointe to the line. One-timer. Fedorov. He scores! What a time by Fedorov. A one-timer from 60 feet. And it's 4-0 Detroit.
This is certainly the worst nightmare for the leaders of Colorado with all the pressure they put on themselves with the meetings that they have had and saying that they will win this hockey game.
Now Gusev pass up the middle, intercepted by Maltby. Takes a shot, now he shoots and scores! Kurt Maltby makes it 5-0 Detroit. And a goaltending change, Darren.
Well, Patrick Waugh will leave this hockey game. He's given up 5 goals in this contest. Detroit has had 25 shots on goal.
To be anything but the go-to guy, he doesn't have to. Whatever he contributes is a bonus.
Yzerman went pointless in game 3. Shanahan went pointless in game 3. Neither one have a point in this hockey game tonight. They're getting it all from the Russian unit.
Poster trying to tuck it in. Maltby with a chance, scores! Billington was down on the original save. On the Koser wraparound, and Maltby gets his second of the night to make it 6-0.
And I forgot to mention Kirk Maltby as well. Second goal of the game for Kirk Maltby. They've got 2 from Larionov. They've got 1 from Kozlov, 1 from Fedorov, and 2 from Maltbyov.
There's Nicholas Lidstrom. Stopped up by Lemieux. Now Kaminsky. Trying to center it. Can't do it. We'll try again. Into the goal mouth. And it's cleared away. Here's Vernon down, puck loose, Lemieux scores! And as you said, the best players have to be the best players. Lemieux from Kaminsky and Sakic, and those are the names you've got to hear if Colorado will be successful tonight.
Got it in.
And stop the clearing attempt. Maltby will try the far side. Lemieux waits for it. Leaves it for Ozolich. Shooting. Rebound. Scores! Claude Lemieux! Sergei Fedorov over the line. Doug Crown the shot. Patrick Waugh there. Kaminsky rolls it ahead. Here's Sakic with Lemieux. 2-on-1. Sakic scores!
You can't give Joel Sakic 2 breakaways in 2 shifts. He's going to make at least one of them count. That's Kaminsky from your old blue line. Just make sure to go both.
Now Aaron Miller gets it ahead. Here's Stefan Yell. Quick shot scores! John, this is playing out like a mirror image of game 4 so far.
Here does come Chris Osgood. A little quicker than I thought.
With a skate, went wide into the corner. Lidstrom kept it in momentarily, and now Sakic has it at center. With Lemieux, 2-on-2. Sakic with room, fires, scores! Here's Young picking off the pass. Kaminsky's on the ice. It's sent in, and Kaminsky's after it first. Tries to center it. It's Denvers in front. Save, rebound. Scores, Scott Young.
Detroit ready for a change here. Picked up by Larionov. Larionov left to wait for some help. He got it. LaPointe, his shot.
Score! Martin LaPointe finally has his first goal of this series. Patrick Roy had this one, and it somehow powered its way through him. Oh, man, what a shot.
Doug Brown, Brown in, his shot. Roy hit the D. Detroit changing behind the play. Brown in the corner. Aaron Miller was on him. Kozlov, the pipe. Kozlov. Center, Fedorov, big score!
Play. Fantastic move by Kozlov. Watch this move here on Ozolin. He looks like he's going to go to the front of the net. Nope, I'm going to go wide and behind. And he leaves Ozolin in his tracks. But Sergei Fedorov, who missed a lot of this hockey game after the wind was knocked out of him, right now has scored a gigantic goal.
He has 91 points in 85 career playoff games. And the Avalanche are down 2-0. And it bounces over Lafave's stick. Here comes the captain. In. Rebound. The backhander goes wide by Eisenman. Eisenman centers on Waugh. And he bats it away with a paddle. Up to the blue line. Held it again by McCartney.
Boy, Sylvain Lafave kept Steve Eisenman from having the forehand move as an option. That might have been the only reason he missed.
Dead Marsh near side to Foot. Foot moves it in. Foot tried to drop it off. McCartney had it. One shot on. Save. Rebound. Shot. They score! Young puts it home. It's not over yet.
Man.
Scott Young waiting out in front. The BU graduate and the U.S. Olympic member for 2 years makes it a 2-1 game.
They get it into the middle. Lemieux was hanging back at center. Waugh heads off. The chance to get the puck up. Shanahan blocked it. Shanahan missed the empty net at the other end. Back to get it as Foot. You're looking at the time remaining. Third period. Detroit leading by one. Larionov the poke check. Forsberg. Larionov goal. Got a piece of it. Again. Shanahan. Is it for the finals? The shot. Yes! Yes!
The man that Scotty Bowman said, you got to come through for us, Brendan, has played an incredible hockey game, matched up against Claude Lemieux the entire tilt.
A two-man advantage for the Detroit Red Wings with 14 seconds in the first penalty. Fedorov in. Big chance early here for Detroit. Fedorov looking, goes back on top. Chelios Lidstrom playing on top on the power play. Eisenman shot. Score! Right up over the shoulder of Patrick Roy. And there was still 3 seconds left on the first penalty, so the power play is going to continue.
Check this out. Oh, man, what a shot by Steve Yzerman. And the Red Wings have quieted this crowd, and in the process, I think, have really shot the Avs. The Avs came out with a bunch of jump, and Detroit is matching them.
Ozolinch is open. Ozolinch got covered. The wrister was blocked into the corner by Draper. Lost to Deadmarsh. Deadmarsh and Dandino did battle. Forsberg looking out in front. Forsberg with a D cutting in shot. Just wide. Rebound. Forsberg. Big save. Rebound. Flying. Score.
Boy, what a display of power play force this game is going to be. You also got to point out that the Detroit Red Wings, I've always said, the most underrated thing about this team is how smart they are. They are a disciplined team.
Shot by Foot. Score! Deflected in front of the net! And a Deadmarsh! 2-1 Avs! Right back in, the dump pass to the corner. Detroit just wanting to get it set up here. Kozlov along the near side. Kozlov drops it. Tomas Holmstrom. Holmstrom, the battle's in front. His shot deflected. When the clock stops! Packed in a play by Kozlov! everybody to the far side away from the pile. And it is a 2-2 game.
Have no idea what it hit, but it came loose just long enough for somebody to hit it. I think it might have been Kozlov as well.
Faceoff won by Sakic. Turns to the near side for Sakic. Good hold in by Larry Murphy. Dump. Wire back to get it. Live trouble with it. McCarty to hit on DeFreeze. Maltby had it. Maltby lost it. Pope checked away. Maltby got it back. McCarty looking. They go back on top. Maltby. McCarty. McCarty lost his helmet. Goes in behind the net. Stepping up. Chris Chelios. Chelios pinched. Held it in. Back it goes to Draper. Draper looking out in front. Draper center. Score! Maltby! Curt Maltby! The overtime goal! And the Detroit Red Wings have won it by a score of 3-2! First overtime game-winning goal in the playoffs in his career.
Right, what great work down low. This is the first point by this fourth line of the Detroit Red Wings in the playoffs so far. And it turns out to be a hugie. Curt Maltby left alone in front. And you kind of tell that the Avs were breaking down in front because Kozlov was alone just a minute ago. Curt Maltby was wide open.
In this first period, just slow Detroit down.
Ward a shot and a pad stop by Waugh. Cycling along for Shanahan, locked up by Dale Hunter, but he escapes and plays defense. And score! Iserman! And it's 1-0 Detroit.
Talk about moving the puck quick. Bang, bang, bang. Patrick Waugh could hardly move. The puck was just zinging around like a pinball. From the draw, the Avalanche have put on the ice in a very slow change their checking line.
And at this time, we welcome those viewers who are watching the action on Fox television in the United States. Some technical problems have caused all sorts of grief for people here. There's a goal as it's centered for Steve Yzerman, and he scores his second of the hockey game and eighth of the playoffs.
Again, a quick one. Just like the first goal was, Yzerman gets his second goal of the hockey game. This has been a total Detroit period. Maybe that early penalty to Lefebvre prevented the Avalanche from coming out and playing desperate hockey like they had to do, but it's Shanahan to Yzerman. Bang, bang. Very similar to their first goal.
And remember, Detroit doesn't have Larionov, that fine player who can play the point on the power play in the second unit. He's down with a hand injury.
Swept right to Lidstrom, cranks a shot, he scores! It may be off Holmes from in front, but the Red Wings have gotten a power play goal and lead 3-0.
Now the thing about it, Mike, is if Holmstrom doesn't deflect it, at least he's involved with the screen once again on Patrick Waugh. Waugh didn't see this shot until it went by him or through him. Offensive zone penalty. Colorado has hurt themselves in that respect, and Detroit keeps this business-like approach. The way Bill Ranford's been playing, too, he looks like Dominic Hasek in this game.
I think he would like that comparison, John. Thrown to the front, Lidstrom fires, score!
This time it was Wendell Clark in front of Patrick Waugh. It's hard to stop it when you don't see it, and Patrick Waugh had no chance. Earlier it was Holmstrom in front. Detroit is just getting it done. This time, it was Wendell Clark. All you have to do as a defenseman is get the puck through. And that's what Lidstrom's been doing.
They look into the middle. Lidstrom cutting from the other point. Shot, shot again, and he just missed. Rebound shot, side made, and deflected off to the other side. Detroit putting the heat on here on the power play. Alf Samuelson had stuck up. There's Samuelson. Dumped off. Tomas Holmstrom. Power play is over. In. Shot, second. They have done that consistently. Shot, Ozilinch, wide, rebound, hit the post, no angle. Shot again, two of them by Forsberg without an angle. Rebound near side, Sakic had it, lost it, comes back to him, Sakic leaves it. Looking, Forsberg centered, shot! Oh, score by Lemieux! Oh. How did he rip that baby home? Claude Lemieux! And still a long time left on the Colorado power play.
Why did this look like a finely oiled machine?
So Claude Lemieux has come through with his first goal of this series.
Yeah! Wow, cool. Did he pull the trigger or what? Bang.
After he lost the puck.
Murphy back to play the puck. Knocked down by Theo Fleury. Fleury doing battle to hold it in. Did for a moment. Ozolin. Ozolin. He'll take the shot. Save made Ranford. Rebound Fleury. Score! Theo Fleury. Great rebound. And Colorado has taken a 2-1 lead.
The big names are coming alive from Bob Hartley's Avs. You had to think that guys like Theo Fleury, Peter Forsberg were not going to go down as easy as they did on Sunday.
In this series, Shanahan will gun it in. Patrick Roy knocks it down, trying to catch Detroit in the change. Kaminsky. Kaminsky dished it off the wall. Here's Drury. Drury a chance. Score! And Dale Hunter! Hunter just came off the bench, took it on the near side boards, and that is the first bad goal we've seen go in against Bill Ranford in a 3-1 Colorado.
What a great play by Valeri Kaminsky to keep this puck moving forward so that Dale Hunter could catch up to it. That's about all Dale Hunter had on the speedometer.
You get Hunter scoring a goal, you've gotten some help. Glenn cleared that one back out. Hunter again, far side, leaves it. Into the middle, Sean Podine is open, couldn't get it to him. Reichel back it out to Podine. Podine tied up. Podine still's got the puck. Podine wrapped around the chance, save me. Rebound Miller, that deflected, stop! The rebound, a 4-1 lead. Two quick goals.
How about it? And this is with Detroit's top D pairing of Chris Chelios and Nicky Lidstrom out on the ice.
Chris Drury's first ever playoff goal for the rookie. Aaron Miller the assist. And the last three goals scored by Colorado have all been even strength goals. Theo Fleury brought it in. Deflected Miller. It hit his glove and went in. It is a 5-1 lead. Bill, we said before the game, it's going to be tougher for Ranford at home than it was on the road.
No question. He had no pressure in Colorado. Yes, he was playing in the playoffs. But this is the jolt. And this is hockey town.
Yzerman has the only goal for Detroit. Back for Yzerman. Looking for Shanahan. Cutting goes on top instead. Wristed Ward. Deflected away. Adam Foote. Foote cleared it up. Ward trying to hold it in. Took a slash to the face. Penalty coming. Delayed call. Yzerman shot. That one deflected. Score! Rebound! And it's on top! Doug Brown looking in front. Brown takes it. Deflected off Lefebvre's stick. Back up to Chelios. Kozlov. 14 left on the power play. Kozlov takes it.
Well, Paul Dvorsky is going to send at least Adam Foote off. I'm not sure if he's going to send Marty Lapointe off, but it doesn't really matter, and neither does the goal for that matter.
Scotty Bowman had them skating that way in the warm-ups. He has changed the lines now for the game. One back. Ozolin shot. That one blocked out deep. Kozlov, Shanahan, Lagana blocked it. Back in. Ozolin shot. Save. Rebound. Chris Drury scores! Drury, the rookie, gets his second career playoff goal. And Colorado continues to get the lamp lit by guys they don't expect to do it.
Made all the starts here in this series for Detroit with Osgood not ready to go. No miracle to back up again. Wrist shot, Ranford a save, rebound, that was open. Score! Billy Ranford was off balance. Adam Deadmarsh picked up the loose puck, and it is a 2-0 Avs lead.
Gary, the same kind of play as the first goal with Chris Drury this time coming off the boards to make it happen. I mean, really good. The puck is going to go over this way. Watch Drury come off the boards and make this a win here for Adam Deadmarsh.
Intercepted by Alton Samuelson. Powered by Colorado. Forsberg up to the other point on that. Shot in, deflected near side. Samuelson and Forsberg. Forsberg trying to dig it out. Hey, Duke Kaminsky. And score!
A centering pass! The centering pass deflected. Hey, Duke may have gotten a piece of that. And Billy Ranford had no idea where it was. It is a 3-0 game. Power play goal, Colorado.
Well, I'll tell you what. They may not be doing it with volume, but the Avs have been a patient team willing to wait for what the Red Wings give them. And now the other rookie, Hajduk, scores. And we've seen this before as recently as two nights ago.
Wow.
Had the Avs a little high in the zone, so they had them outnumbered down low. Wendell Clark had the puck, just couldn't make the pass. Wendell Clark has been another guy that's been real quiet.
Forsberg score! Peter Forsberg came around from behind the net. Let the shot go, and Norm Miracle not ready for that backhand chance. Just like that, out of nowhere, a goal and a 4-0 lead.
And the people are heading to the exits here in Detroit.
Came back to Miller. Boy, they had a great chance right there out in front. Drop. Lemieux trying to tie it up. Forsberg. Forsberg still controlling. Forsberg along the blue. Miller leaves it. Shot in front. Miracle score!
Norm Miracle reaching out, couldn't get it, and Kaminsky, who's playing in his second game after coming back off the forearm injury, has made it a 5-0 game.
And Peter Forsberg is putting on a clinic. My gracious, the passing of Peter Forsberg.
Back up to Murphy. Murphy and Chelios, power play points here. There's Larry Murphy. Murphy drops it off. Set up in front is Holmstrom. Center pass. Score!
And I don't think anybody else tipped that. Wendell Clark was standing in front, may have got it. But I thought Kozlov had it hit a D. We'll see in the replay.
Yeah, hit somebody. It may have even hit somebody's skates, which is unusual because the Red Wings are giving up more shots than they usually do.
Kind of surprising in the playoffs. Intercepted. Hayduke coming, moves it out. Detmarsh in the middle. Detmarsh score!
What a pass! A perfect 2-on-1. Adam Detmarsh the goal, and it is 6-1.
6-1. Colorado on top. 31-24. The shots in favor of Detroit. Kozlov shot. Score!
Rip shot over the shoulder. So Kozlov gets his second.
The two Detroit goals off his stick.
Flings a long pass as the Avalanche are changing. Kozlov drifted back. Pass misfires. Dale Hunter brought it ahead. Odgers a shot. Oh! Chelios moving ahead, dished one over for Yzerman, but will go and take the pass himself. Rocked by LeFevre. 2 seconds and one now. Penalty time is up. Out of the box comes Detmarsh. Moving ahead is Forsberg. He's got Detmarsh. He got it to him. Detmarsh moving in.
Detmarsh coming out of the penalty box, knew he had a chance for a breakaway.
Forsberg didn't have the pass for Lemieux because of McCarty. Now gives to Ozilinc. His drive went head high at the glass. Spike back out in front, off of Forsberg. Kept them miraculously. Ozilinc, Lemieux, Forsberg, score!
Forsberg power play shot right over the shoulder of Chris Osgood.
Off the near side boards as Yzerman double shifts with these two wingers. Up the near side, Lemieux trying to clear it out. Jamie McCown would let him, and it came away 2-on-1 chance again. Brought in, Kaminsky looking, drop the shot, score! Peter Forsberg, that's what we were talking about. The odd man rushes, and Detroit pays the price.
Absolutely, Gary. Peter Forsberg started this play by beating Steve Yzerman in a one-on-one confrontation deep in the AV zone along the boards. But then Detroit was a little too aggressive, and that's how they got the two-on-one.
Hayduke, a little room. The rookie turns. Forehand chance.
Look at the move! Hayduke shot! Side way! Centering pass by Fleury off Hayduke. That's a rookie, folks. Ozilinc holds it in. Theo Fleury back into the middle for Sakic. Stepping up, Ozilinc. Ozilinc open. Ozilinc in. Tried to center. Behind the net does. Hayduke headed deflected away.
Up to the point. Not out. Aaron Miller. Miller. He'll get it in. Deflected. Score! Hayduke!
Milan Hayduke, the rookie. He deserved it.
Man.
And a 2-0 Colorado lead.
Boy, is this kid any great or what? It's not any good. Is he any great? What a play he made to start this thing off, and then finished it off with kind of a funky little deflection that Chris Osgood couldn't get back into position for. Chris Chelios just tried to dump it out of the zone.
Nothing doing. Aaron Miller stopped it with a stick, and his skate was backing up the stick.
Cleared it around the near side. Up, Brown got it out. Again, can't handle it. Lefebvre over. Kaminsky's open. Kaminsky in. Dropped it. Drury shot. Score! The rookies! Unbelievable! These rookies are doing an incredible job! It is a 3-0 lead. Hajduk and Drury, two rookies, with the last two goals.
And the, Gary, on this one, it is perfect. Team D getting back in the neutral zone, patiently waiting for the turnover, and then coming with your world-class transition game.
Nobody has ever won the Hobie Baker Award as the number one college player in the country and the Calder Trophy as Rookie of the Year, ever. That may change because Drury is probably going to win the Calder Trophy as Rookie of the Year. Red Wings, shot Fedorov, save made, rebound Clark, bounced away from him out of the zone. Good coverage that time, and Detmar steals it. He's got Sackett. Detmar shot. Short-handed Sackett. Score! It counts! It counts! A short-handed goal. There was no whistle. Joe Sackett stayed with it, and it is a 4-0 Colorado lead.
Boy, did it ever help Colorado that Carey Fraser was on the right side of the ice to see that Chris Osgood didn't have the puck smothered. But clearly Igor Larionov is having trouble handling the puck with that cast on his left hand. He fumbled it, and Adam Detmars was right on him. And boy, these guys can smell it now. Yes, the game is only half over.
Played back by Clark. He's in front, but not directing it by Patrick Waugh. Lidstrom shot. Waugh got the stick out and deflected. Off the boards, the clear. Sackett can't get it out. Eisenman held it in. Near side Lidstrom, one-timer Eisenman. Got his man down. Shot. That deflected in front. Back to Eisenman to Lidstrom. Score! Murphy starts it up. Got it away to McCarty, to Shanahan. Ozolinch kicked it away. Shanahan held it. McCarty in front of the net. Back to McCarty. Went through it. Gill, the one-timer. Score! Was this hit with a high stick? That was Patrick Waugh's immediate argument.
Aaron McCarty, who has been absolutely snake bit, is going to get credit for this one, I believe. Oh, yeah. Well, we said this has been a bizarre series, and it looked like the Colorado Avs were in complete control of this game. They've still got a two-goal lead, but check this building out now.
As the minutes tick off here, in fact, seconds, Detroit will continue to charge. Ever more pressure. Brown again, hauled down in front. Taken out of the play by Sylvain Lefebvre. Intercepted. Short-handed chance. Forsberg, 5-on-5 in. Forsberg shot. Score! Peter Forsberg! Oh, the talent. The cream rises to the top. It is a 5-2 Colorado lead.
Oh, my gracious. What a play by Peter Forsberg. We saw it all on this rush. His strength, his perseverance, his talent, his hands. Oh, baby, what a play by Forsberg. This is a magnificent goal. Absolutely magnificent. What a sport, huh?
How you could possibly think this was going to be a sweep. I mean, one club dominate. They're, both of these clubs are so good.
Here's an odd man rush. Forsberg. Their graphic. This is the first time in the playoffs that the Red Wings have trailed. Back on the line, Ozolich. Now for Forsberg again. To the corner, Drury. Looks for the give and go. Back to Ozolich. Now a shot right to Forsberg. Forsberg puts it to the left point again. Ozolich lets it go. He scores! A power play goal by Ozolich.
Detmeyer's the hard wraparound. 1:12 left on the advantage. Held in. Drury came up to help on the long. Hajduk in. Hajduk a shot. Side. Hajduk scores!
And this is why the Colorado Avalanche is such a dangerous team. Milan Hajduk did not have a shot on goal in game one. But you knew that was not going to last long.
4-on-3, Colorado with a power play. 50 seconds worth of this 4-on-3 advantage. Forsberg brought it in. Forsberg in. Shot. And score! Peter Forsberg! He may be the best player in the game today. And that's why.
Well, watch this play. This will tell you that Peter Forsberg's luck is changing. The puck stayed with him. Nick Lidstrom made a dandy poke check.
Colorado has won all their home games here so far, 4-0. Trying to add a number 5 to that. Chelios is going to chase deeper.
So hard to get through the neutral zone. 5 Avs players back most times. Okay, Chelios got the red line. Look at this!
Hallstrom scores! Down the board! It took a bad bounce! Wow, went back to play it and ricocheted into the crease, and it is a 1-goal game. Woo.
Finally a break for the Red Wings. Now the question, can they do anything with it? The Avs allowed the red line. Chris Chelios dumped it in. It took a weird bounce off Patrick Waugh in front.
1:12 left to go.
Did the Mark Bergevin with better results.
Got it going in the right direction. Chelios to flip into the zone. Back to get it is Clem. Clem and Miller are out there as the defensive pairing. Empty net. Score! Waugh intentionally directing that over to the near side corner. Larionov had stepped up. It'll be holed into Shanahan working a point now. See if he stays there or not. Nope. He drifts to the front of the net. Shanahan now to the high slot. The point in front. Over to Lidstrom. He's got a cannon. Fakes. Got his man down. Looking into the middle. Shot. Score! Forsberg on top. Forsberg will take it. That deflected off Darren McCarty. Up for Raymond Ward. Ward dropped it into the corner. Jam up here. Good work, Detmeyer. Back to Hajduk. Hajduk to Bork. Bork looking. Hayduk's open. Hajduk trying to set up Bork. One timer. That deflected Eisenman. Rebound. Score! Peter Forsberg again. It is a power play goal and it's tied 1-1.
Wow. What a rocket. Great execution by the Avs on this power play. It looked like the Red Wings were going to be able to dodge the bullet because they got McCarty out of the penalty box.
Yeah! Left the camera.
That would be lights out for one of our cameras.
Not going to talk about contract, but we certainly will. And I said, if I say you're coming back.
People are coming alive for the Red Wings.
Empty net. Waugh's gone. That puck hit McCarty in the head. I think it was the puck that got him on the far side. Empty net. Shanahan. This game. Bang! A point. Ward. Ward looking to center and it's locked in behind the net. Drury's there. Drury up for Reed. Dave Reed will move it out. 17th year in the NHL for the veteran Reed. Near side Tanguay. Tanguay just jumped over Gill. Back to Tanguay. No in front shot. Score! Finally! It was a turnover and a mistake. And those are the things that are going to decide this game. And of all people, John Clem cheated in off the right point.
and found himself alone.
Good read by John Clem. There really was no fear to move in because the Red Wings had all collapsed back down low.
Vetterov line back out. Reed will clear. Gill will chase down. Tipped away at center. Holmstrom looking. Vetterov near side. Vetterov in onside. Vetterov to Brown. Brown a shot. Holmstrom! Terry Fraser, see anything that happens here in this power play by Detroit? Look out, shot, Fedorov, deflected, Fedorov, save, score!
As of right now, the man that was a healthy scratch in Game 3 stands to be the hero of Game 4.
The penalty was at 9:12. The goal was at 9:20. Kozlov from Fedorov and Eisenman on the power play. First lead change we have had in this series. They have the two offensive defensemen together. Sakic. Sakic cut off. Hacked at. Beat Draper doing the work down low. Hey, Duke got the puck though. Hattic, Ozelich. Ozelich looking. Ozelich will take it. And it went wide. Rebound near side. Footsteps up. Centering pass. Bounce off. Everybody. Side. Stop. It counts. It counts. Dave Andrechuk, and this game is tied at two.
What an amazing play. It was Milan Hajduk who took the first swing. And I'll tell you what. I think Milan's Hajduk contact was above the crossbar, which makes it really important that the puck didn't go in.
Hit the post.
Hit the post. Dave Andrechuk came and got the rebound.
Shanahan in. Skula knocked it down. Skula knocked it off the wall but fell down. What a play by Skula to tie up Eiserman. He was down on the ice 2-on-1. Forsberg looking. Forsberg dropped it for the game winner.
Sequence. The Red Wings thought they had Martin Skula down, so they pushed up, and in doing so, allowed a 2-on-1 the other way. It looked like Martin Skula, the rookie who was playing for Ray Bourque, missed his chance to get out of the zone, but then he dove, and he got a chunk of it. Adam Dedmarsh came back to support. A triple on the board. Watch this pass by Peter Forsberg, and then Chris Drury. You think this guy is not a big-time player?
Face off one by Colorado. Sakic scores! And he's smothered there on a good defensive play by Lindstrom. Now Lariana knocked it down. Miller steps up, fires. Rebound scores! Stefan Yell! By McCarty, Andrechuk centered, and that was blocked by Osgood. Hajduk all alone in front.
Osgood just saved the goal.
Here's a chance for Larry Murphy. Scores! Larry Murphy shorthanded, and the Wings get back in it.
And they're alive. Sitting, waiting for Detroit. Now they're going to counter.
Here's Forsberg, winding up, scores!
Five in the neutral zone, Forsberg ends up with it, and does he rifle this thing or what? Right off the post, he gets all of it. Oscar doesn't even move. He just tees it up, drills it.
Back into the lineup if you go on.
Well, we'll have to see. You know, the team's playing well right now, so we'll keep going until we don't do so well, I guess.
I know they miss you a little bit. Good luck getting back in, Jeff.
Thank you.
There's Jeff Rogers and Chris, a goal by the Red Wings.
And there's Brendan Shanahan, Scott, and the Red Wings will not go quietly.
And this all started off the faceoff.
More icing, good hustle there. Here's a shot by Odell, rebound, scores! Sean Pardine!
Because first of all, they lose the battle on the icing. There. And play continues, and the fourth line, as you mentioned, Messier doing all the work, and who is in front to take Pony? I mean, that's a mess.
In 24 chances this playoff year, they are eighth among the playoff teams in killing off penalties. Drury's a trailer here, straight down the middle, shot, score, Sakic! He didn't miss that one! Joe Sakic, surprise Dominic Hasek, and it's 1-0 Avs.
Boy, I think he surprised Dominic Hasek, Gary, because it looked like Joe Sakic was losing the puck a couple of times.
Lidstrom will be working a point near side Shanahan. Shanahan, the lookout in front for Holmstrom. Brendan Shanahan near side Fedorov playing back along the blue line. Lidstrom. Colorado not wanting to give these shooters a chance along the blue line, coming out to play the puck. Shanahan shot deflected wide of the net. Holmstrom rebound.
When the puck came back out, right there, Holmstrom sitting on his rear end, drilled it home.
Tomas Holmstrom creating the havoc, will get the power play goal. Maltby brings it up to the top, he'll take the chance. That's blocked right there in front of him by Adam Foote. Foote falls down on the ice, 3-on-2 the other way. Colorado trying to create a 3-on-3 Detroit. They got a back, psychic save, rebound, tank it, rebound, score! Hajduk! Milan Hajduk, 2-1 Avs!
What a play! What a play! This is the line we talked about having the jump. Oh, gracious, do they have the jump. Even plays that look like they're going to bog down, they make something out of.
Delio starts it up. The Avs changing it up again. Left in the middle of Datsyuk. Datsyuk, Forsberg, the back check, picked that one up.
Well, that's where Detroit has gotten into trouble. The last 3-on-1 that didn't work for Colorado, but they're turning the puck over. Detroit is just inside the blue line.
Datsyuk shot, save made, rebound!
Rookie Pavel Datsyuk, what a terrific job he did. He cut his way through a couple of people.
Constantly is hanging around cup team. Shot by Fisher, saved by Waugh. That went through. Gary Fisher with the opportunity. Deflected, DeVries got it back out. Tanguay took the hit over there. Back into the middle, McCarty shot, score!
Of a wrist shot for Darren McCarty, and this is called using a screen. Boy, he had Adam Foote in that praying position.
DeVries moving, Colorado changing. DeVries looks, saw nobody there. Hayter Price, Fisher got to him. DeVries back, bumped up into the middle, right over Sakic stick, 3-on-1. Blake is the only man back. Colorado trying to get there. In the middle is Maltby, shot, score!
For Darren McCarty. And don't think the fact that he didn't already score one goal had nothing to do with the confidence to pick the corner on this one. McCarty looked like a 40-goal scorer on this play. What a shot!
Blake knocks it down. Blake sends it back. Intercepted, Chelios to Fedorov. Fedorov tipped it out of the zone. Gains the red. They want to change. Wow, will hold it up behind the net. Well, I had to play that empty net for a moment. Maltby shot, save, what a rebound! Do you believe it? Hat trick, Darren McCarty! Detroit supper of choice this Saturday will be hats and octopi.
Hats and squid right here at the Joe, you bet. There's even one behind Patrick Roy. How did that get in there?
It crawled. Darren McCarty shot it in there, probably shooting everything else in there.
There's not a more popular player on this Red Wings team than Darren McCarty. Nobody is happier in this building than all of his teammates.
Expecting to be up there with Yzerman and Shanahan.
Oh, I'm not so sure. He's a pretty realistic guy.
Deflected shot, Sakic scoreless, and scores! The turnover down low to Tanguay, who finally got it. Great work, Sakic, Drury, and Tanguay with a goal. It's 5-3. It's to beat right now, but if they're going to beat him, it'll be right here. Forsberg, power play, Sakic score! And they do! And Peter Forsberg is on the board early as he picks up the assist on the tip. And the Avalanche, on the power play, have a 1-0 lead.
Well, this is something Detroit didn't want to have happen early, and I'm not even talking about getting scored on. I'm talking about taking the penalty.
Back up, near side boards. Big battle into the corner, Devereaux. Boy, Devereaux turns it back for Datsyuk. Hull, Devereaux still bouncing around. Devereaux got it. Datsyuk knocked down. Hull brings it back, looks for the pick, sends it into the middle. This is tough skating right here. Score!
Comes through for Detroit.
He is tied for first in goals and third in points for Sakic. Fisher tried to get it, didn't. Came back into the middle. Bocek to the point, shot, score, score! Peter Forsberg on a deflection.
Now the Red Wings are going to argue this, but it's going to be pointless. You are allowed to redirect a puck with your skate. You're just not allowed to make a kicking motion towards the net. And Peter Forsberg might not have even been aware that it was going to hit him until it came. Let's see it here. Oh, yeah, he was. Oh, sure he was. What a play. This is a rule that changed last year.
See, only three shots off the power play. Near side, all along, Chris Drury, chance. Went behind and wide of the net. Hasek thought that had gone in. He missed it, but it went wide. Cleared up. And out of the zone again, Maltby. Patrick Roy way out. He's got an empty net. Maltby's got the puck. Roy's going back. Maltby, Roy, Maltby scores! Roy got caught!
Decision, and it has cost the Colorado Avalanche.
Devereaux got it out of the zone. Takedown by Forsberg. They still control. Datsyuk in the middle. Ryan Pratt with the interception. Game opens up again. This game has done this a couple of times. Ryan Pratt splits. Shot. Couldn't get it. Tied up in front. It hit a stick in the centering pass. Score! DeVries! Greg DeVries! And a 3-2 Colorado lead.
Here comes another role player into the mix. A guy that has elevated his game in the playoffs for the Colorado Avs, Greg DeVries. Man, what a play he made by jumping up on this one.
Mike Keane, one of the all-time great penalty killers, playing in his 205th career playoff game. Robitaille, it's cleared around. Now they'll get it set up. Lidstrom, 46 on the Detroit power play. Colorado has the one-goal lead. They set Robitaille in front. Yzerman over to Shanahan. Hino moved in. Shanahan looking. Robitaille's in the high slot. No muscle in front. Shot wide. Rebound up. It is not Patrick Roy's night again.
No. And Nick Lidstrom will take this, but this not, it certainly isn't what he had in mind.
And 50 in playoff overtime game. Knocked away by Peter Forsberg. Got it back, three back for Detroit. Got it back in the middle. Drury again waits. Drury trying to center fan on it. Got it back in the middle of Forsberg. Forsberg, forced inside, shot the save man. Forsberg after the rebound. Drury scores! Out of the corner.
Going to the goal and score. They got into it in the corner. And you know Gasparitis was going to be involved.
I think, is that Chris Chelios? Yeah. Yeah, I figure Chris Chelios might be there. But they'll get this finished up here. What a move by Chris Drury. What a fantastic move. The guy's got no nerves at all. Ice water running through his veins with the move that he made on Dominik Hasek. Gracious me. And Forsberg made a superb move before that. Look at Forsberg's move between the skates. Then he circled back. No problem.
And the Detroit Penalty Killers have given up 7 power play goals in the last 5 games. That's something you can't do in the playoffs. So many goals coming off power play opportunities. Forsberg sends it back to the point. Shot. Sakic score! Another one! Joe Sakic! And Rob Blake will be credited with the goal, his first of this series, his 6th of the playoffs. Sakic and Forsberg at 15:54. Cut to Forsberg. Forsberg left it. Drury just broken up. Good play defensively on the back check made by Sergei Fedorov. His shot blocked. Inside shot. Save made. Patrick Waugh screened by Robitaille on the chance. Fedorov, Holmstrom, Robitaille have done a job here offensively creating opportunities in this game. Or at least cycling down low. Forsberg off the stick of Adam Foote to the near side as he couldn't control. Still loose here to Fedorov, leaves it, centered for Robitaille, blocked again, Foote lost it, Fedorov's got it, Fedorov centered, had nobody there, Forsberg steps in front of that shot, but it went through anyway, Fedorov shot, save, wide, rebound, score! It's tied at 1-1, went off a Colorado defenseman, Greg DeVries.
But this line for Detroit came out on this shift looking like they wouldn't be denied. They have just picked up steam. Watch this, a triple carom off of Waugh, off of the skate of Steven Reinbrecht, and then up into the arm of Greg DeVries, who looked like he was trying to swat it down, and he swatted it right into his net. So three different halves touched the puck, starting with Patrick Waugh. There was the skate off Reinbrecht, then DeVries. It might have nicked the toe of Luke Robitaille, and that's why he got credit for it.
On the right side is Hull, Yzerman with it. Yzerman moves it in. Squeezed out of the play. Close to catching Detroit changer. But Hasek came out to play it. Yzerman gets it back. Fresh legs up. Shot. Score! Frederik Aronson! Detroit in overtime beats Colorado 2-1.
What a blast by Frederik Aronson. Dominik Hasek made it from his crease to the celebration pile in world record time. The Detroit Red Wings knew that they deserved this game. They had the far better scoring chances. Patrick Waugh had the force field up. But finally, Frederik Aronson on a quick break. His first playoff goal in just 10 years.
Drury trying to fire it up here. A little chop on Dominik Hasek as he tried to play the puck. Reinbrecht in the middle. Reinbrecht looking for somewhere to go with it here. Comes back to him. Fisher knocks him down. Reinbrecht hit by Fisher again. Puck loose near side. Peter Forsberg putting the heat on. Loose along the boards. We've had a lot of wall banging going on in this one so far. Down the middle. Blake! And he didn't get all of it. Reinbrecht scores!
You will never see a team exploit another team without a stick better than the Avs did on this one.
Near side to Tange. Tange along the blue line, got it in. Detroit coming right out, challenging the puck. Knocked away, Fedorov. Short-handed Sergei Fedorov, the move. Scores! Sergei Fedorov, a short-handed goal. And the Wings have tied it at 1.
What a play. You had to know, if you're a Colorado power play guy, to be careful, because the Detroit Red Wings had scored 5 shorthanded goals in the playoffs. This makes it 6. What a play by Fedorov. When you get a team on the run, it's amazing how much easier the matchup situation becomes.
And that is exactly what Detroit has going. Sakic shot. Score! Joe Sakic! And the Avalanche have a 2-1 lead. Just what we said. The Avalanche have it tilted in their favor. Brett Hull moves it in. Hull, his shot wide on the far side. Brett Hull still leads his team in playoff goals with six. Drop back off to Forsberg. Forsberg cutting. Centering pass. Dalton Hartrick score. Chris Drury.
What a magnificent pass by Peter Forsberg.
10 seconds left to go. The Avalanche responding in the third period. Wah held him in for two. They're going to go to Detroit Monday. Hull a chance. He scores with 1.1 left. Brett Hull gets his seventh playoff goal with the extra skater on the ice.
Dumped in wide of the net by Devereaux. Played around the far side and up to Forsberg. Forsberg leading everybody in scoring in the playoffs. Brings it in. Shuts it down. Avs changing. Dropped a great pass in the middle. Down went Hasek. Empty net. Score! Ryan Pratt! What a play! Colorado takes a 1-0 lead. He got the goaltender down and then walked it. The 180 to get one.
And the fifth consecutive game now. Every game in this series, Colorado has scored first. The Avalanche know one thing. When you're one-on-one with Hasek, sometimes he'll come out to challenge.
He's had only one goal in the last 10 games. Here's Holmstrom on the power play continuing here. 55 seconds left on it. Lidstrom, Hull. Hull drops it back. Holmstrom trying to get set up in front. Shot, Fedorov. He missed it again.
I think it might have hit somebody in front, but he sure didn't miss it high.
Boy, that thing screamed to the near side. Shot by Yzerman. Covered with the stick by Patrick Waugh on the short side.
It's a goal! It's a goal! They're signaling it went in. Waugh did not get it. This game is tied. Power play goal by Yzerman.
Patrick Waugh is not arguing. I thought there might be a problem for him. Steve Yzerman saying it went right in. Steve Yzerman was yelling immediately, yes, yes, it's in the net, yes.
Took Peter Forsberg by the legs and said, I'm down and you're not going anywhere. Draper trying to rush it in, tied up by foot. Draper lost his stick, cleared up onside. Looking into the middle, Drury couldn't get it. Save, score! Colorado wins the game, Peter Forsberg! Comeback stories in sports history continues to be written by a man who did not play a single regular season game, Peter Forsberg. Tied up in the circle, Yzerman and Sakic. Sakic will get credit for the win. Forsberg trying to kick it out, did not, down low. Yzerman tied up by Blake. Rob Blake just saved a goal. Off the point. Lidstrom shot. Yzerman knocked it down. And Blake saved.
What an incredible finish. What an amazing finish. And Steve Yzerman with another chance. Robbed, it looked like, by Patrick Waugh. I've got it. Oh my gosh, I don't have it. Brendan Shanahan was in there too. But Patrick Waugh thought he had it in his glove, and he did not. He did not.
We'll have to wait for the call whether that crossed the line before somebody else hit it or not, but what a goal.
Anytime around the Benjamins, it's like trying to play dodgeball in a traffic circle when the line changes.
Skula drops it back. Forsberg tipped it into the middle. This could be an on-man rush the other way. On the right side is Maltby. Brought back in by McCarty. Shot. Score! Dan McCarty! And the Detroit Red Wings have a 2-0 lead. He scored a hat-trick in the first game. He had not scored since. He gets one here in Game 6.
And another odd man rush for the Red Wings. Mention that it's a double-edged sword. You send your defensemen, you activate them, you make sure they're involved. But against the Detroit Red Wings, if you make a mistake, you're going to end up with an odd man rush the other way.
Game-winning goals this year. Back it comes, Robitaille, a chance. That got deflected to the point.
Shot, score!
A gut
gutsy goal.
An early goal, and the Detroit Red Wings have the 1-0 lead. In game seven, an immediate LePatrick chance begin here against Patrick Waugh.
They trust the guys to back him up like Yuri Fisher did. Kirk Maltby there, he's going to go and take a chance.
And he did. Detroit changing behind the play. Sergei Fedorov, a shot, scores!
Has had 15 shots in the last two games without a goal. Sergei Fedorov launches a bomb.
Near side, Detroit has to get back onside, and Larionov dishes off for Robitaille, who'll send it deeper. Yuri Fisher waiting for some help to come off the bench. Olsson got hit hard into the dasher. Detroit back though, shot blocked in the middle. Larionov pass a little bit behind Robitaille. Sent back in behind the net. Larionov cycling down low to Robitaille. His open shot, score!
This is one of the reasons Ken Holland, the general manager of the Detroit Red Wings, went out and got Luke Robitaille to score big goals at big times of a hockey season.
And it'll be moved by Duchesne to the far side and out of the zone. Robitaille looking. Robitaille with the loop. Champ goes through two. Backhander, save. Rebound, Duchesne. Score!
Just consulted with Brian Trottier about something. They're looking for answers, and they've got four questions to answer now. Tomas Holmstrom looked like he got to it first.
They all played by the rules. Cleared back up by Fedorov. Man in the middle open. Couldn't get it back to Duchesne, who was cutting in as Boyd Devereaux brought it into the zone. We also have to revisit. Devereaux with the puck left at Hull. Scores! Have been business adversaries for years and years. And right now it looks like they may become adversarial in the Stanley Cup Finals. Centering pass in the power play. Score! Frederick Olsson!
Patrick Waugh looked over to the bench.
What's his call, huh, Bill?
I think it is his call. And here he is, David Abisher. Well, the unthinkable has happened. The Detroit Red Wings have chased Patrick Waugh with an offensive onslaught. Six goals in less than half a game here in game seven. The unthinkable has happened for the Colorado Avs.
Chelios is there. They get Holmstrom in there. Nope, not on this one. That one blocked wide. And down low on the power play is Boyd Devereaux now. Near side Hull, look at the passing. And a goal! David Abisher could not get back in time. Dotzer could get it. 7-0.
Detroit playing the fourth line with Darren McCarty on the right side and young Darren Helm centering that fourth line.
Icing canceled. Helm with the check on Haydu. Chipped on for a pass around behind. And turning was Smith and centered in front. They score! Smith with a slick centering pass for Paul Stastny. And it is a 1-0 game. The Avs have struck first. But Lidstrom was able to take the pass back. Rapolski head up with a pass on now to Zetterberg. Trying to work his way by. Shoved off, though. Little feed in front. Backhander! Score! Defensive move by him. Under 6.5 to go. Virtually non-stop in this first period. As along comes Cleary. Tried to punch one further that did bounce on for Pronson. Moves up with Filppula. They crisscross. Gave it on to Cleary for a shot high off of Theodore. And it goes in!
Well, the play through the neutral zone for the Red Wings. The center drive. Johan Franzen distributes the puck over to Daniel Cleary. He takes the shot. Nobody has an idea where this puck is.
McCarty came in, and all of a sudden Holland and McCarty started talking about the pass. And Babcock kind of felt left out.
Here's Hudler handing it to the back. Sent on by Cronwall to Hudler again. Cronwall, a shot, deflected, score!
Johan Franzen, 27 goals in a regular season. He's off to the right of Theodore, and as that shot is coming, he gets to the front of the net and redirects it. The ab problem, like that's an ab groin problem for Tomas Holmstrom.
Franzen forced off. He's got a goal and an assist in this game so far. This one skipped along. Brunette is charged in two. It is finessed right back over for the feed to Franzen. He scores!
You got to think Joel Quenneville's thinking about a goaltender change to try to change the momentum in this game early in the second. It's Peter Budaj taking over.
A bit of a mishandle by Osgood. Didn't bounce the way he wanted to, but it is flagged by Hannon and turned back out to center. Brought back ahead by McLeod. Giving up the wing now to Lyles in the shot. He scores! John Michael Lyles, and it's 4-2.
We talked about the transition game, Doc. This puck does not get in deep. Brett Lebda was going up, moving up on the rush, and then the quick pass there by Cody McLeod.
Here's Zetterberg twisting along at a backhander. It's batted away.
I think that dance is from back then, isn't
You're
it?
Yeah, I think you are. I think you are right on that. Brought ahead by Smith, finessed on to Stastny. Oh, he's away, got it for a score! Hey, Duke! What a play! And the Avs are back to within one.
Well, Ryan Smith makes a great play. This is a 3-on-2, and if you're a defenseman, and it's Brian Rafalski, he bites. Ryan Smith sells it. He comes all the way over. Now, what's this do? This opens up the center of the ice, and then Lidstrom comes over to try to bail out his partner.
Always facing the puck. That's the key with number 7.
It is Samuelson. Could not play the point just yet. No one had arrived. Now Cronwall is there. Walks it across. Deals to Samuelson. Fake the drive. Then shoveled one. Deflected. Score! It's Franzen again.
Well, Pierre, you were making mention of a little bit earlier that the Avalanche have to win the faceoff. They did this one. And Johan Franzen beats Kurt Sauer back to the puck. He lifts up his stick. And then Franzen realizes he can get to the front of the net. Samuelson moves the puck. And watch this. He kind of shanks his shot. He just off the side of the net. And a beautiful little redirect on the backhand.
No flamingos on that one. As though you got two guys from Colorado wanting to get in the lane.
Gotta pay a price.
Played by Cronwall, forced around behind by Franzen, given on to Hudler, finesse to Franzen, he turns and has help there in Cleary, walked out in front, back in a score! Do you believe this guy?
Well, a terrific backhander by Johan Franzen. But he makes the play when he takes the puck around and he skates away from the goal. He comes out. He doesn't go into the crease. He skates out a little bit and elevates the puck. It's going to open up space, try to cause some confusion for the defenders for the Red Wings.
Vilppula dropped on back, gave it over to Lidstrom, plays it ahead now for Dallas Drake. Northern Michigan product drilled one that was guided away. Rebound, score!
Well, the transition game, defense to offense.
I guess that's the lead, so. Played back on by Holmstrom and brought back ahead by Zetterberg. Another odd man rush. Zetterberg moves in. Score!
Well, decisions in the neutral zone. Kurt Sauer, the defenseman, decides he wants to move in. Wrong decision. Give up a two-on-one. Holmstrom goes hard to the net, pushes back Adam Foote, and the quick shot by Henrik Zetterberg. You got to make better decisions in the neutral zone.
Jose Theodore, again, being pulled. He's trying to make sure he gets the right people on the ice in terms of keeping the flow of the game going.
Cody McCormick with this one, and the shot was blocked down. And Carr! Just as soon as it looked like it was out of trouble, it was in trouble. Ian LaPerriere has made this a 4-1 game.
Well, the Avalanche got what I would anticipate that they wanted, an early goal.
Back out now for the play by Brunette. Drive by Sackett, got the glass, rebound. It's sent down around behind. This is all Avs right now. Arneson holds and gives it on to Linka. 1:10 still left on the power play, but a two-on-one shorthanded. Zetterberg moving in. He's got Franzen. Crosses, toes, shoots, save, Budaj, rebound. They got a point, score! Franzen, the hat trick.
And there's hats on the ice here at the Joe.
That's creative general managing, getting a player like Johan Franzen, Håkan Andersson, Jimmy Neal, Kenny Holland, the entire brain trust of the Detroit Red Wings. All they do is keep stealing players. Everybody says they buy their teams, Enzo and Doc, they draft their teams. They do an outstanding job here in terms of player procurement, and Johan Franzen's a great testament to that.
Held in by Arneson, down deep, Cody McLeod. McLeod along the wall. Arneson at his side, the crowd loves it. A delayed whistle, a penalty against Detroit. Arneson, the extra man on, Hensick. Looking for Arneson, TJ Hensick, a shot, he scores! How do you like that? A tip out in front. TJ Hensick in his first NHL playoff game gets involved, and Colorado has a 1-0 lead.
This looks like it's going to be McLeod's goal. He was standing right at the top of the crease.
At 11:55, Detroit, their second power play as they bring it ahead. Pavlodatsu, Zetterberg in full flight, cutting, moving in the slot, they score! What a play, and moving up on it, Pavlodatsu, Detroit has tied it.
It's Lindstrom carrying the puck until he's challenged at the red line, and then it's just a little back diagonal drop pass, and what that does, John, it gets the penalty kill, is kind of standing still in the neutral zone, and when you have Zetterberg and Datsu coming late, behind the puck carrier with speed, and you want to play physical. LaPerriere wants to be a physical presence, but you got to stay within the rules.
Samuelson's shot answered by a Theodore save at the point, held in by Stewart. Back of the goal, Leopold on his man, Franzen. Johan Franzen tied up by Jordan Leopold. Samuelson and Gitte are there too. They continue that scrum. It pops out. They center one. Rolls off the stick of the man activating. That was Lebda. In the slot. They score! Johan Franzen continues on his great run. And Detroit has a 2-1 lead.
Great pressure by the Wings. This is why they are the top team in the National Hockey League, certainly through the regular season. Their ability to possess the puck. In the offensive zone, they wear you down, they tire you out. their constant motion, their good puck support, their ability to find open space.
Henrik Zetterberg goes to work on Adam Foote. He plays him well. Datsyuk, Hajduk are there too. It's underneath Adam Foote. Referee says move it. They do. Datsyuk up top. Rafalski winding it. In for Holmstrom. Holmstrom back to the point. Rafalski shooting one tip. They score! Pavel Datsyuk. Beautiful hands out in front. Detroit by a deuce.
That's a one-on-one battle going on. Holmstrom and Sauer. And Peter Forsberg leaves Rafalski at the right point to go in and make body contact in this one-on-one. And that opens up Rafalski at the point. Now someone's open, and it's Datsyuk right in front of the net.
Forsberg sends it back for John Michael Lyles. On the wing now, it's Hajduk. And on Hajduk, defended by Dan Cleary. Lyles hammers one. They score! Redirected out in front. A bomb from John Michael Lyles. Power play goal. Colorado within one.
I believe this is going to be Andrew Burnett's goal. He was working the slot area. But a nice umbrella setup up top between Forsberg, Lyles, and Hajduk. LaPerriere couldn't do it. Foote had a chance. He looked real tight at the back end of this penalty kill. He couldn't get it out of his own zone either.
About 16 left to go on the power play. Datsyuk playing catch with Zetterberg. Getting control. Shot taken. They score! What a pass, Datsyuk. It finds its way to Zetterberg. And Detroit is back up by two.
This is one of those passes that you make, Pavel Datsyuk, that is. Well, you just never admit that it wasn't intended for Henrik Zetterberg. It may have been intended for Holmstrom in front of the net, but because they're in a linear formation, if Holmstrom doesn't get this feed from Datsyuk, Zetterberg will.
Burnett holding on to it. Now Henzik moves it deep. They play catch. The rookie gets it back for Soleil. Here's Joe Sakic. He has to settle it down. He walks in. He centers on the target. Osgood can't get it. Andrew Burnett on the doorstep. Colorado within one.
Just a little pump fake by Joe Sakic at the left point.
Ruslan Soleil. We saw the New York Rangers in game one. Push it to game five against Pittsburgh. Colorado tries to do the same tonight. Samuelson with a shot, and it rolls in! Theodore had it, and he lost it. Michael Samuelson gets the goal. Detroit is off and running.
Goaltending has been a topic of conversation here in Colorado.
Tyler Arneson, backhand saucer. Here's Sakic, tipped by Lyles, fended off out in front. Sakic again, Lidstrom, pressured on the play. And on Hajduk in back of the goal. He has Arneson out in front. He elects to go to the point for John Michael Lyles. This way now, it's Joe Sakic from the wall. Holding onto that puck. Detroit dropping back in that box. Inside Brunet. Arneson scores! Tyler Arneson set up beautifully by Andrew Brunet. Colorado's tied it.
The Avalanche get three real good looks with this man advantage. Quality power play. The opportunities were there. Arneson run one off the post.
Against Minnesota, stopping 96 of the last 100 shots he saw in that series. Datsyuk, Zetterberg is away at his side. Holmstrom, two on one. Zetterberg holding. Holmstrom there. They score! Thomas Holmstrom set up by Henrik Zetterberg. And Detroit has a 2-1 lead.
Obviously not the time to get caught pinching or thinking offensively in the offensive zone when it's 1-1.
Back out to neutral ice. Under a minute left to go in this first period. Stay tuned for the Dodge Intermission Report. Hockey Central coming your way next. Give and go time. Franzen scores! The Mule comes through again. Johan Franzen. Detroit by two. 7 goals in 4 straight games for Johan Franzen. 9 total in the playoffs. Leads all players in terms of goal scoring in the Stanley Cup playoffs. Johan Franzen scoring at 19:42. Foote punishes Datsyuk a bit. It rolls back for Lidstrom. It's a 5-on-4 for Detroit. As they orchestrate, Lidstrom one-timer taken. They score! Henrik Zetterberg with a blast. Power play goal. Detroit in control.
Patience. Patience with the man advantage. Detroit
because they have Lidstrom and his ability to quarterback a power play and move laterally across the blue line, it allows Zetterberg the time to find open space on the umbrella side.
Colorado gets it out.
Colorado went for a line change, John, in the neutral zone and allowed Chris Draper that open lane on the right side.
Datsyuk with Holmstrom. Datsyuk holding the trailer. Zetterberg, Budaj to save, and they score! What a goal! Henrik Zetterberg, top shelf on his backhand when he was down and out. 5-1, Wings.
Attack, counterattack, continue to keep the pressure on, and this is a highlight goal by Henrik Zetterberg. The spin around, backhand, all in one motion while he's being knocked down. Datsyuk sets up the one timer and has foots up, ending Zetterberg. The spin around, backhand that makes it to the top shelf.
His second goal tonight, his seventh of the playoffs. Pavel Datsyuk gets the assist at 5:45. At the point, second. One timer, Lyles, he got underneath it. Arneson tracks it down, but it's broken up by Zetterberg. It's a two-on-one, shorthanded. Zetterberg along with Franzen. Franzen alone. They score, and they make it look easy. Shorthanded goal, Johan Franzen. 6-1, Detroit.
Colorado got a couple of looks on the power play. Hajduk had a chance on a slap shot from about the tops of the circles. Lyles a one-timer out high. And when you're down by one, you take more chances, even on the power play. And Detroit's going to be able to cash in.
50 seconds left in the Red Wing power play. Lane catch with Samuelson. Kubler looking slot, dealing low, getting it back from Cleary. All the way across Lidstrom. His shot scores! Could have been redirected out in front. Franzen was on the doorstep. 7-1, Detroit.
No question this was redirected. Johan Franzen, with timing, getting to the top of the crease. He's got the hot hand. He's getting hotter, I think.
Hey, Brick, is there a better 1-2 punch for in front of the net on a power play than these two guys, Franzen and Holmstrom? I can't think of one.
No, no doubt.
I mean, and Franzen, you know, foot battled with him a little bit, but finally he got tired of dealing with him. You can't move the guy.
And a change for Colorado.
Guys, you talk about an intense Mike Babcock. I ran into him before he had his morning juice, and he was already lamenting. Oh, sorry.
That's okay, Billy. Don't worry. Michael Samuelson out in front. They go to the goal. A beautiful combination play. 8-1, Detroit. Center zone, Sakic, here they come. The trailer is Brunette. Sakic again, back to the point. Lyles holding onto it. He'll set it up. Soleil gives it back. Lyles again up top. They score! Brunette was out in front. John Michael Lyles with a shot. And Colorado gets a power play goal.